Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the dimension tool in Adobe Illustrator. This is a fairly new tool for Illustrator. In fact, it's still in beta form, but if you're a Creative Cloud subscriber, you can go ahead and download it and use it now. I'm sure there'll be some modifications to this tool before its final release, and when that happens, I'll make an updated video. For now, let's talk about what's available here. We use this tool to both measure and plot distance and angles and the radii and diameters of circles. And we can change how the results are displayed on our screen. The tool's located on the left toolbar. Here's what it looks like right here. Now, when I click on the tool, I get a flyout toolbar with four icons on it. The frustrating thing about this is if you're going back and forth between other tools, each time you go to the other tool, the dimension tool closes and you've got to come back and pull it out again. I'm hoping that's one of the changes Adobe will make. In these icons, the first one is what we use to measure distance. So with the linear dimension active, I can come over and hover on a side of an object, and you can see that it's telling me it's 3.64 inches between the left side and the right side. I'll click down with my mouse and drag up, and it's going to plot the distance here on the screen, and it plots it where I release my mouse. I can also drag to the inside of the object, and wherever I stop is where Illustrator will leave the measurement. Now, it's measuring only the rectangle. So if I measure an object that has a thick stroke on it, and this particular rectangle has a 10-point stroke, Illustrator isn't going to measure the stroke. It's only going to measure the object. So I'll come here and drag up. And you can see the extension lines on the left and the right, and they're coming from the center of that stroke. Just FYI, your strokes are always by default centered on your object. So what we're getting, 5.4 inches, is only the measurement of the object. Now, if I wanted to measure the object with the stroke, there's a little hack here. It only works with rectangles. I'm going to hold the Option key down and click, and Illustrator is giving me the measurement to the outside of that stroke. So you can see I have 5.54 inches instead of the 5.4 inches. What Illustrator is doing here is actually measuring where the bounding box would be. So let's come down and look at this star. When I click on the star, you see a bounding box here, and what it does is it shows the far left, right, top, and bottom of where the object is, and that includes the stroke. So if we come over and get our tool, and I hold the Option key down, and I click on the object anywhere, Illustrator is going to give me the height and the width of the bounding box, so I'm actually getting the measurement of the stroke as well. Now, you're probably never going to need to measure the bounding box of a star or a circle, but being able to measure a rectangle with its stroke might come in handy. The other way to use this tool is to measure things manually. And what I mean by that is I'm going to click here on this object. I'm going to hold the Shift key down because I want my line to be straight, but I'll come over and click on this object here and slide a little bit, and Illustrator measures and plots the distance between these two objects. And sometimes that might be helpful. Now, to measure an angle, we come to the second icon, click here, and we start at the corner, and you can see 90 degrees is showing up. And as I see it, I'm going to drag to the center, and Illustrator, as I release my mouse, will plot the angle. If I want to measure the outside angle, I press down with my mouse and I drag to the outside. This is 52.54 degrees, and you can see how that works. Now, with the circle, we come to the radial dimension icon. I'm going to come to the center and I'm going to go to the outside. And as I do, you can see the radius is 2.38 inches. That's what the R is standing for. If I click down, Illustrator plots it. And if I start at the center, move to the outside of the circle, press down with my mouse, and begin rotating along the circle, you can see Illustrator is measuring the diameter of the circle, 4.75 inches, and when I release my mouse, it plots that value. Now, this last icon is the Dimension Tool Options dialog box. It looks like a lot here, but as we go through, we're going to find out it's really pretty straightforward. And this is where we are able to customize how these different lines are showing up on our screen. First of all, my document is set to inches, and so my plotting is showing up as inches. But if I was working on a project where I needed this to be in a different unit, I can click on this pull-down menu and I can choose whatever unit of measurement I want. I can change the scale and I can also change the precision. I'm going to leave this to 2 decimals. The dimension lines are the lines that show the dimension, and we can change the weight of these. Let's increase this to 3 points. I can change the type of a line. Right now I have solid lines. I can change these to dashed, or I can change them to dotted. I'm going to change this to dashed, and I can change the color. So I'll click here. I'll just choose this red here and say okay. Then I can choose the arrow style. And here's a little pull down menu, which gives me a lot of different choices. Let's do something fun here. I'll choose this arrow, and then I can make the arrow larger or smaller by changing the arrow scale, and that's not going to change the line weight, just the scale. So I'm going to highlight this and type in 75% and press the return key. Then I'll come back to the linear dimension tool and drag this out, and you can see how those changes have been made. Now, the same thing will happen on the extension lines. These are the lines that come up on the sides of the dimension lines. The difference is I can choose the offset. Now, the offset is how far the gap is in between the lines and the object, and the extension is how far the line extends beyond the dimension line. Let me just make one change here. I'm going to change this to a dotted line so you can see what that's going to look like. And if you decide you don't want extension lines, you can click this little box here. And before I exit out here, what I think is the most valuable is being able to change the size of your text. I'm not as concerned with the font family, but these numbers look a little small to me, and I can click up and make them as large as I want. I can change the color of the text. I can also change the position of the text. So the first 2 icons allow me to either position the text above the dimension line, which is default, or below dimension line. I like it above here. And I can also choose whether it's aligned left, aligned center, or aligned right. And then finally, I can choose how far it's offset from that dimension line. If I wanted it to be further away, I would increase the number of the points. Now here, if you have a suggestion for a change that might be helpful for everybody, you can click on Share Feedback and give your suggestions to Illustrator. I've already done that several times. And finally, if you want to go back to the default settings, you click Reset and say OK. Now, those changes weren't reflected on the measurements I already had on the artboard, but they will be on anything in the future. So let's drag this down here. We have the extension lines, which are now dotted lines, very, very small dots, and the font size has been increased. The last thing I want to show you is in the layers panel. Illustrator creates a separate layer for the dimensions. Now, if you're not accustomed to working with layers, I'm going to leave a link to a tutorial at the end of this video because layers are such an important part of how Illustrator works. I'm not going to go into any of those details here, but watch the video and you'll understand what I mean. I am going to twirl down the dimensions layer here and you can see all of the different measurements are showing up here. And you might not want to deal with these individually, but I can come over here and click on this little eyeball and I can turn all of them off at once without deleting them. So they're turned off and now they're turned on again. And I think that is a really helpful tool. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video and that you'll download this tool and begin playing with it. And if you find improvements that you think should be made, be sure and let Adobe know because in the end, it'll help us all. Now, before I go, I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials. And I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.